Rob T07, hello doc, if after a few months on atorvastatin 40, if someone's LDL dropped from 120 to 47, would you still recommend switching to rosuvastatin? Great question, Rob T07, and the answer is yes, I would, and here's why. We talked about pleiotropic activities when we're talking about K2. A pleiotropic activity is you give it for one thing, but it actually helps on something else. Here's what happens with statins. Mostly statins are given to lower LDL. But think about the logic. And I know you've seen a lot of our videos. I've seen you around a good bit in terms of your comments. Half the people that have a heart attack have a normal LDL. So is it really LDL that's causing this? Probably not. On the other hand, there's a big thing in terms of inflammation. I'm not going to go down that trail right now, but there's a very smart guy named Paul Ridker at Harvard who noticed this over a decade ago, that whether people's LDL was low or high, quite often if they were on statins, they still had a significant decrease in heart attack. And well, if they were on statins, they had a significant heart attack risk. He theorized that it was due to inflammation, and that science has been proven out multiple times. Why did I go down that path? Because here's the problem. People are still taking atorvastatin, Lipitor, watching their LDL and thinking they're getting a good impact. Lipitor is the least likely of all of the statins to impact inflammation. It still does. But here's two things. If you're a female, it's less likely. And if you have insulin resistance, it's less likely. Over half of us have insulin resistance or diabetes, and half of us are females. So, and the by far the biggest prescription given in the statin area is Lipitor. So from that perspective, I would say a huge portion of statin prescriptions are doing more damage than they're helping.